First lesson.
Yes.
This is great.
Okay, so first we're gonna have a little chat and just ask a couple of questions.
Yeah.
So you said you had somebody to work with your voice.
Mm-hmm.
What happened? Was the
So I had one singing teacher all the way up until year seven, from year three to year seven. And then I had a classical trainer, and I'm not really into classical. And
what's your favorite genre?
I love like pop. Like modern music, really.
Awesome.
And like theatre. I don't mind musical songs.
These are my musical songs.
Yeah.
Okay. What's your dream?
I really like performing. Just anything to do with performing. And really, I love.
Before we do anything.
Yeah.
I need to hear you.
Okay.
So once I hear you, I know exactly what to do with your voice.
Yeah. I'm not good with like high. That's what I want to improve. It's like getting my range higher, because I'm really comfortable in like the lower ranges. But then when it gets a bit higher, I'm not. I guess I'm like scared a bit to go higher.
We're only scared when we don't know how.
Yeah.
You know, something that we are uncertain about makes us feel anxious.
Yeah.
You know, this is absolutely normal. Once you know how, it's like riding a bike, you know, once your brain kind of accepted that you can.
Yeah.
Even though theoretically we all know we can learn the right bike, but then we're still wobbly when we try it first. That's because our brain is adjusting new thing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. How about we will try Listen by Beyonce?
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah.
It's just quick and easy way for me to understand your voice, really. Grab the mic.
Uh-huh.
And off we go.
Listen to the song here in my heart, a melody I start but can't complete. To the sound from deep within, it's only beginning to find release. Oh, the time has come for my dream to be heard. They will not be pushed aside and turned into your own, or cause you won't be said.
This moment you use about 25-30% of your potential voice.
Yeah.
Okay. 70% in 6 months.
Okay. Yeah.
If you follow the technique.
Yeah.
Turn the mic off. So and what is happening is obviously the breathing is not there. I mean, you had few coaches, isn't it?
Yeah.
What did they tell you about breathing?
The classical one was more like helping with the breathing a bit more.
Okay.
So she was like, make sure you hold your hand by here, like feel the movement a lot more.
Right.
And yeah, she just taught me a lot of things in like one lesson. It was really hard to like remember it all.
All right. Okay. So
it's your voice. So she'd like kind of every lesson we'd go a bit higher, and if I could get a sound, she'd like.
Okay, forget that.
Okay.
Okay, so we're gonna forget about that completely.
Okay.
So I'm going to stretch your range.
Okay.
Okay. So there is two type of the range. So first is the maximum range of yours, right? It could be even funny little noises on top and funny noises on the bottom. And it doesn't matter, because there is another range which called working range. So the working range is the one that you're going to use in your songs, okay? Yeah. So your working range has to be pretty much in the middle of your general range, mm-hmm. and you have to have at least 5 to 7 notes yeah. on top of your working range and at the bottom of yeah. your working range, okay? So you feel very comfortable, mm-hmm. okay? So the breathing, of course, most important thing. Now yeah. look, when we whisper,
yeah,
we use very little of the voice. Now at this moment on the top notes you kind of yeah. do whispering, okay, yeah. because you don't send enough air,
okay
so the strength and the power of your voice depends on the air mm-hmm. and the speed that air goes through your vocal cords. Now where okay. the vocal cords are,
here.
That's right, are they vertical or horizontal?
Horizontal.
Well done. So this is our throat.
Yeah.
And this is our vocal cords, mm-hmm. right? Now what happens, look, I'm going to show you something and that will help you to understand
okay.
that, you know, with regard to approaching the higher range, mm-hmm. okay? So look at that. When we breathe,
yeah.
they will open up yeah. like that. Yeah. And then we make noise, right?
Yeah.
So we do,
yeah.
And then we do,
yeah. Yeah.
Anything changed?
No.
Exactly. That's the most important thing that you need to understand.
Okay.
Nothing changed if we sing high, lower note.
Yeah.
Or higher note. So vocal cords don't go anywhere. So yeah. when you think, oh, I go somewhere up, you mm-hmm. shouldn't think that way, because for vocal cords is absolute nonsense, isn't it?
Yeah.
They stay at the same place.
Yes.
The only thing that happened to vocal cords when they go up is they stretch a little. They get longer.
Yeah.
You know that?
Yeah.
Awesome! Brilliant! So we go through theory. Very brilliant. That is brilliant. Okay, fantastic.
Oh, dear me. Yes.
Now, yeah, so now the only one thing that you need to do
yeah.
to help you approach higher range is to send the sound back, or think about sending it back.
Yeah.
This is a little bit weird, isn't it?
When you pull it back instead of pushing it forward.
Exactly. Yeah. When you push it forward, what happens is that you put the soft palate down. Now, what is soft palate? It's at the back of our throat, isn't it?
Yeah.
So we have hard palate behind our teeth.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
Then we go back with your tongue. Yeah, uh-huh. and then we reach that soft area.
Mm-hmm.
What is great is that soft area can become hard. Okay, now this is massive in with regards of the making a powerful sound. Okay, why? Because we add additional resonator. So imagine that you go to the shower,
yeah,
and you're sitting there,
yeah,
and you feel good,
yeah,
yeah. Why?
Because it's like really. Like the acoustics are
good. It resonates, yeah. isn't it? Why does it resonate?
I don't know.
Well, usually we don't have a soft material,
yeah,
in the shower,
no carpet,
isn't it?
Yeah,
that's right. So hard surfaces reflect the sound.
Okay
soft surfaces, like in the record studio,
yeah.
you have foam stuck to the yeah. walls, isn't it? It takes the sound,
yeah,
so the sound very dry,
mm-hmm.
so it would not be any disturbance when
yeah.
you do recording, right? So it's the same if we open our wardrobe and we will sing into our wardrobe.
Yeah.
It's going to sound dry, okay? Now, when we're in the shower and the sound reflects, we hear that very, very well. And we think we sound today really amazing, isn't it?
Yeah.
In the shower. So with the soft palate, when you lift it up enough,
yeah,
then it turns into a hard one, really. And it become hard surfaces.
Okay.
So that means that it reflects the sound. So all the sound that the vocal cords produce actually comes, reflects to the soft palate,
yeah.
and comes out nicely.
Okay.
What you have really good thing, which so often I need to teach my mm-hmm. singers to do, is to smile when you sing, but you smile anyway. Even when you go on the soft, very little sound on top notes, it's that you have gorgeous smile, which is another ding, cakey, you know. But you use, that's another kind of little helper and resonator.
Yeah, she's always told me to smile a lot.
Absolutely. Yeah. And why? Because teeth are hard and they reflect the sound.
Yeah.
And if you would cover it with your lips, they're soft.
Yeah.
They would take the sound. That's the explanation.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
Of that. Great. So we just passed that. And now with regard to breathing.
Yeah.
Okay. The reason why we shouldn't use the shoulders is that there are two big, well, first of all, there is no lungs. Nothing can help our singing. Okay?
Yeah.
And there are also two sets of muscles that go across like that.
Mm-hmm.
And they connect to our neck. So if you will try to move, breathe with your shoulders, and then you have adrenaline, for example, when you go on the stage and you will be nervous, adrenaline will give you heart rate and all that kind of things. Yeah. You might have a shaky voice.
Yeah.
And quite unstable. You might crack on the top note or something if you use shoulders. Mm-hmm. Okay. Because the muscles are connected to our throat.
Yeah.
If you use them, they have tension. Tension moves to our throat, here we go. We have tension all over the place, okay, which we don't need. Now, yes, indeed, with the tummy, this is where we need to breathe.
Yeah.
Absolutely correct. But how do we do it, you know? I'll show you, for example, if you need to shout loud.
Yeah.
Somebody, you know, you see the friend across the road and you say, hi there!
Yeah.
Do it.
Hi there!
Very good and nice and loud. Okay, so that's your belting sound.
Yeah.
Okay, now go a little bit higher. Hi there!
Hi there!
It's a little bit hi there. You see? So you try to sing it, and I need it. Literally, say it nice and loud, but a little bit higher. Hi there!
Hi there!
Oh, there! That's doubled now. You doubled your voice, and this is your belting voice, okay?
Yeah.
So we go into, when she said, you know, be careful, don't damage your voice, that's certain things that we going to, as I said, forget, because whatever exercises I will be giving you are safe already.
Yeah.
Okay, so they will be safe. If even if you will try something loud and belty, they will be safe because they will start from sending some of the air through your vocal cords. Okay, now the flexibility, the powerful and flexible singing, okay, it's all about using different air compressions.
Yeah.
Okay,
okay.
Going through your vocal cords.
Yeah.
So what it means is like changing the gears.
Yeah.
Okay, we need to learn how to change quickly the gears. We need to learn lots of different air compressions through lots of different exercises, and then being able to combine them and use them in all the different kind of orders and everything.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's going to go through the exercises as well.
Okay.
So my set of exercises will improve your voice if you want it or you don't want it, okay? As long as you do it, okay?
Yeah.
So, and there will be a couple of exercises that are great indicators how well you're breathing,
mm-hmm.
okay? So for example, the easy one, and I'm sure that you know that one, is the lip trill.
Yeah.
We can't avoid. Yeah, absolutely. Now, can you do for me, for example, Twinkle Star?
Okay.
And try to not to breathe too many
with
times.
With the lips.
Yeah, with the lip. So we're going to try here. No. Let's try to go as far as you can without breathing. Okay? Go. Okay, that's very good. Except that you started to help yourself with the tiny office, which we don't need, isn't it?
Yes.
So when we do exercises, we remove any unnecessary movement.
Okay.
So we're turning ourselves into like a robot, like singing machine, you know. All the mind is on the correct singing. Then you go on the stage, you can jump on your head or arms, you know, do whatever you want. But you will be prepared. It's like in boxing, you know, they do this routine thing, boring one, and then they go on the ring, you know, and smash each other's faces, you know. That's fine, because then come back, they come back and do again the boring stuff, to get their muscles ready, okay? Mm-hmm. So we're gonna do the same thing for your muscles.
Okay.
Or for your vocal cords.
Yeah.
We're gonna stretch them,
mm-hmm.
and we're gonna make them stronger.
Yeah.
Also, we're gonna make the right muscles that support your voice.
Yeah.
We're gonna make them stronger too.
Okay.
And those muscles are not the ones that you use when you, for example, lift up heavy
mm-hmm.
things.
Yeah.
Those are big muscles in our tummy.
Yeah.
We need smaller sets of muscles.
Yeah.
To be flexible enough.
Mm-hmm.
Tummy has to be flexible enough.
Yeah.
Okay? And I'll show you the exercises which makes it really, really comfortable.
Okay?
Okay?
Yeah.
We're going to try at the end of the lesson, we're going to try listen again.
Okay.
And see what we could improve with that, okay?
Yeah.
Fantastic, very good. You can put the mic on there and I'm gonna show you a couple of exercises, okay?
Yeah.
Awesome. So when we will finish with the, I will explain you, have a seat, how we're gonna work.
Yeah.
This is what we're gonna do on the regular basis, and then at some point when I see the exercise is getting quite easy for you, I'll take it to the next level of exercises, and this is how we're gonna do it. Okay, now to start with, let's go through lip trail, two arpeggios, and don't stop until I stop you.
Okay?
That's the rule. I know your voice at this moment and your potential much more than you do, because your brain limits you at this moment. You know, this, I can't do this, I can't do that.
Yeah.
It's a very typical thing for the brain, because the brain at this moment doesn't know how, okay? So I'm gonna sometimes confuse your brain and then very quickly stick in a new technique,
okay?
Okay, so wherever you can reach in lip trail, you potentially can reach with the full voice. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Okay. Wherever you stop doing lip trail, that means at very that moment you stop supporting your voice properly.
Okay. Yeah.
It's a great indicator how you breathe. Okay. Two arpeggios, one up top jump. Okay. Two, three, go. That's very good. Well done. Now, a couple of things. First, I want you to learn how to work with yourself.
Okay.
So I will be kind of talking head.
Yeah.
And I don't want you to rely on me. I want you to learn how to rely on yourself.
Okay.
This is why the mirror is there.
Yeah.
So whatever we do, I want you to look at yourself through the mirror.
Okay.
It's not rude. I prefer that. Okay. This is really something that I rather you to do. I want you independently to look after your voice, even if I'm not around. Okay.
Yeah.
So I want you to look in the mirror and try not to do this knocking that you do, okay? We don't need that. Two, three, go. Okay, brilliant. Now, we're going to add a decent, solid breathing, okay? So now I'm going to ask you, of course, not the moving shoulders.
Yes.
But every time you go up, I want you to push to me.
Okay.
So three times this for this exercise particularly. Two, three, go. Okay, now with the jump, you need to make sure that you push them in when you go up and then you relax.
Okay.
Slow motion. To push them in for the jump, okay? Two, three, go. Job with your breathing. Now this note, you know the song Loving You, Loving you, it's easy because you're beautiful.
No.
She does whistling there. Okay. And you just did those notes, which I guarantee you will have in around 6 months, you will have whistling there. So you will be doing Ariana Grande kind of, or Mariah Carey kind of whistling. Okay. Yeah. You know they kind of.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
This is what you're capable with, and I can guarantee you it's absolutely, absolutely easy to achieve. Okay? Very good. Now, you see you've done it on the lip trip absolutely easily. You reached that note nice and easy. Can you try it out with your voice?
Okay. It's not gonna
count. How funny, isn't it?
Yeah.
So your voice is not reaching the note, and yet you just did it with your lip trill.
Yeah.
Because you were just busy doing what I asked, you know, something was working, diaphragm was supporting it perfectly. Now your brain is saying, what are you talking about? I don't know if I can do that, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So, but that's fine, because the theory 100 always works, you know. We do 100 times, and it's yours now.
Yeah.
Yeah? So, If we do consciously 100 times correctly, then it goes to our subconscious, stays there for life.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Here we go. You're going to have those notes. Okay, let's go down. 2, 3, go. No. That's the note. That's right. 2, 3, go. Bridget, you've just been there before. It's not high enough. 2, 3, go. Yeah, 1. Given to recovery, if singers did operations, something happened with the voice, you know, the doctors would actually prescribe that this exercise. Okay. But I use it anyway as a prophylactic, you mm-hmm. know, just to keep voice healthy. Okay, it's a V, so very,
very,
yeah. So we're gonna do 2, 3, go. Okay, so now you have some ideas with how intensive it is.
Mm-hmm.
So the classical singing involves much lighter support, much lower air compression going through the vocal cords, okay? With our belting, the air goes much faster
mm-hmm.
and it's quite intensive, okay? Yeah. So it's like, you know, when we cough or sneeze,
mm-hmm.
you know, this funny statistic that air goes like something like 100 miles per second or something, isn't it? Very, very quickly. That's exactly what happened to the vocal cords and the voice. Now, very important that you remember that scientists have discovered, it's quite recently, you know, 5-6 years ago,
that there are two different parts of the brain that are responsible for singing and for talking. It's fascinating for us because we suddenly realize that whoever says that breathe normally for singing is wrong, it's not gonna work. Okay, because that part of the brain that sings has no idea, doesn't know how to breathe for supporting the voice properly. When we were little babies, and that part of the brain that responsible for talking, that part of the brain was actually practicing since we were tiny baby. When we started to do gaga, boo boo, baba, you know, all that, this is how that brain, part of the brain, was learning to support our speaking voice. So it's very natural for us, okay? But when now we've discovered, you know, another part which helped as well massively was the autistic kids, because you probably heard that autistic kids could don't respond, because I help some autistic children.
My uncle's
autistic. You can sing to him, and it will be just brilliant, you know. So for us, it was massive discovery, because sometimes there was no eye contact, nothing, when I talk, and yet when I sing to them, they respond. That's because the another part of the brain is involved in that, okay? So that part of the brain does not know, it's not natural. For that part of the brain to support our voice. So that part of the brain turn on the emergency breathing. What is our emergency breathing? If you struggle with breathing, your doctor is going to ask you to do big chest breathing. Okay, that's an emergency. And the brain is like, okay, I don't know otherwise, so I will turn on my emergency breathing, and you do and you sing. Okay, it's only because there is no other options for the brain. Okay, now you will have that option. You know that every time you go up, you push them in, you go down, you relax. That's the basics that are gonna try to, they're gonna completely settle your breathing for singing. Okay, now the very, very serious exercise for breathing is, I call it individual breathing. Okay, if you will nail that one, you will take yourself to the whole new level of singing. Okay, and this is, do you have a dog?
Yes.
Amazing. So you know when they're hot, how they breathe. That's right. Absolutely. Now, if you will now pay attention at their tummy, you will see that it's only the tummy that goes in, out, in, out, in, out. Okay, it's like basically like this. That's the only way how they can breathe long time. Same for us. I'll show you. Same for us. If we if we try to breathe like this, we're gonna get ourselves into trouble. What we need to learn is just to breathe with this kind of doggy kind of breathing. I call it individual breathing. I'll show you. I'll explain you why. We need to try to do it just with the tummy. No, that's true. More tummy. I want it really proper wobble, you know, very good amplitude. Better. Yes, well done. Now, don't do it too long because you will feel dizzy. Because once you will do in, out straight away, oxygen doesn't stay long enough for blood, so you get dizzy. So stop. You will be fine literally 5 seconds after you stop. Everything is just very safe. Okay? Now, once you will concrete, once you will nail this kind of breathing, you will need to add sound. Go. No, that's isn't it? That's from the throat. And this is what you need to achieve, okay?
Okay.
It's challenging, but it's a massive change for your voice, okay? So you need to keep 80% of the air and 20% of the sound. So don't give me the big sound. Okay, that's better. Now, look what we're gonna do. We're gonna do this exercise like this. Now, you do out, 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 out. And I need out, in, out, in, out, in. Individually for each note.
Okay.
Breathe up more air. Go.
but that's a good start. Okay, this is something that we need to polish to perfection. And the reason why is that next level is going to be this. Supporting your voice that easily. It cost me nothing in my throat, and the muscles are big and strong enough to support it to the perfection, and you can do anything you want. Okay. Also, it's great exercise if you need to catch up the air straight away. You will be in a system. You don't have to build a wheelchair from the scratch. Okay. Now, belting. This is this exercise is for belting, and this is something that's very safe to do.
Yeah.
Okay, have a seat. And you can easily try how far you can go, how strong you can go on this exercise. Okay. Of course, with your breathing. And the rule is always the same. You go up, you push to me. Okay? And then you relax. Now, say, way!
Way!
Very good. Way!
Way!
Awesome. That's your belting.
Yeah.
This is how powerful your belting can be.
Okay.
Okay. So we're going to try to confuse a little bit the brain. We're going to almost say, I want you to activate both parts of your brain for that kind of singing, talking and singing parts of the brain. Because your singing parts of the brain at this moment is doing, if you would just use singing parts of the brain, would be, way!
Yeah.
Yeah? Not way!
Yeah.
Okay. Mm. I don't want that air compression being strong, okay? So, what we're gonna do, we're gonna do this exercise on a pure belting. Take your time, but I want you to think that you're saying this, actually, instead of saying, don't do way, rubbish, you know? Whatever is safe, I know it's safe.
Yeah.
But in the entertainment industry, safe is boring. Yeah. Safe is boring. Okay? So we're going to do wait. Like that. 2, 3, go.
Wait.
Yeah, one.
Tanya, what is she on there? What note is that?
G.
Is she?
And for the belting,
I'm just in awe of you, Tanya. I'm just like, wow. Jen, you are as well, aren't you? We're like, this is amazing.
Okay, so
incredible, Tanya.
We're gonna We're gonna really
incredible.
Try to make a good sound now. Okay, so. Grab your mic and let's do lessons. Listen
to the song here in my heart.
Say it, brother.
A melody I start but can't complete.
Now exaggerate time for now.
Listen.
Relax straight away.
To the sound from deep within. It's only beginning to find.
When you do tummy though.
I am alone.
Okay. Now, if you will do it with the tummy, you're gonna do it from your throat. That's a tricky one. Okay?
Okay.
It has to be individual breathing. Ha, ha, hi, hi, hi,
hi.
Yeah.
Okay.
Say hi.
Hi.
Hi, Maya.
Hi.
Yes.
Okay.
Good girl. Okay. Keep going. In your tummy. So as soon as you push, relax.
Okay.
Like you do, for example, if you cough or sneeze,
yeah.
You don't do a chip.
Yeah.
And you stay there. No, you do a chip and you relax.
Yeah.
Or you do a ha and you relax.
Yeah.
So it's always have to be like a seesaw. Once you tense, you relax straight away.
Yeah.
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 Then only it works. Once you relax it, then you have again a good platform for the next note. Tense, relax, tense, relax. Yeah.
Okay.
So at this moment, exaggerate. It's not going to be like this on the stage. You're not going to sing like this. Okay. But I want you to learn the flexibility with your tummy. So pretty much wobble it at each note. You know, it helps so much.
Okay.
It gives us that kind of relaxation that we need at this moment for your voice. Okay? You know, just constantly in and in and bubble, 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 bubble. And then tummy, it might not match with the notes sometimes, you know, but it will give the idea for your brain, completely brand new, because your brain at this moment is like, what? Okay, but it's okay, it's okay, because okay. The wobbling will gonna give your brain new idea of breathing. She drops it. I'll show you.
Now I'm done believing you. You don't know what I'm feeling. I'm more than what you made of me. I followed the voice you think you gave to me. But now I gotta find.
This is in pop industry, you know? So we picked that. I just wanted to show you. Of course, the last part is mega hard.
Yeah.
For a young singer. You yeah. know? Not the younger age, but young with regards yeah. of skills and knowledge. Okay. But at the beginning, what I wanted to show you is that you doubled, more or less, you doubled your voice already.